going to deal with the topic that is methods and techniques of training. We're going to focus on off the job training method, and this is part two, and this is one of the most predominant part of human resource management, which covers almost all courses of UgCnet MBA, BBA, Bcom, Mcom, and I will use more practical aspect and approach so that it will be convenient for you to memorize the topic. I have made part one also regarding on the job training method. Do check that video, and this is a continuation with the methods and techniques of training. So let's get started. This is my introduction. This is Shalini Khatwani. I'm an MBA in the field of finance and marketing from Sri Shankaracharya Group of Institution, Bhilai, Chhattisgarh. Previously was working with the Kalinga University as an assistant professor in management, commerce department, location in Narayanpur, Chhattisgarh, and currently preparing for UgCnet Management. So students, basically there are two types of methods of training, on the job and off the job. Let me give you a briefing regarding training. Training is the most important function of human resource management. See, due to globalization, okay, and due to increasing competition, the local companies just not have to face the competition with national company, they have to face the competition with international company, multinational company. So to remain updated and upgraded, training is the predominant part of any business organization. Training enhances the skills, enhances the knowledge, capability, potential of employees that are working in a business organization. Different trainings are given to different methods of training are used, as well as training is used in different departments, whether it's a marketing, whether it's an IT, whether it's a research, whether it's a production department or material department. So training is a prerequisite part of any business organization. So there are two methods basically used for training. On the job, I have made the video regarding on the job training. Do check that video. When the training is given to an employee, when they are working actually, okay, learning by doing, this is termed as on the job training, as well as they get paid also. Okay, there are different methods of on the job training: job rotation, coaching, job instruction, mentoring, understudy, committee assignment. Now today we're going to focus majorly on off the job training. When the employees are taken away from the workplace and given training by a trainer, different methods of training are used. So we're going to discuss in the further slides in depth. So let's start. See, off the job training, see, this is a trainer and these are trainees. Okay, see, when the employees is taken away from the workplace, okay, they learn in under the guidance of trainer, okay, under the guidance of trainer, and through different methods, for example, role play, case study, simulation, or I would say role play, case study, simulation, games, business games are used. Okay, so these are some of the methods of the job we're going to discuss in depth. So let's start with the meaning of the job training. Okay, when employees hold training away from the workplace, when the training is given to employees or trainees not in the workplace, they're taken away from the workplace so that there will be less distraction, because in on the job training the employees are learning as well as working, so there is a distraction. They have to focus on work also, they have to focus on enhancing their skills and knowledge, whereas in off the job training method they are just focusing on learning. Okay, learning, enhancing their skills, enhancing their knowledge, their capability, their analytical skills, conceptual skills, making themselves more productive and contribute towards achieving the vision. Okay, during this type of training, employees express their views, their opinion, and explore new idea. See what happened in on the job training methods, the training is given by their supervisors or manager, so they are little bit nervous to express their views, their ideas, their opinions, whereas in off the job training method they are very free to express their ideas, their views, and they explore new opportunities in their workplace. Now these are the methods of the job training: simulation, case study, classroom lectures, role play, business games, which we're going to discuss in further slides. So let's focus on advantages. See, every methods have some advantage, some disadvantage, as we studied it on the job training method. So here we're going to focus on advantages of the job training and disadvantages of the job training. Decrease employee turnover. When organization is giving them training on the regular basis, okay, making them updated, enhancing their skills, enhancing their knowledge, capabilities, so what will happen, employees will feel motivated, and employee turnover rate. What is employee turnover rate? When number of employees are leaving your organization, okay, And see, most of the organization are facing the problem of employee turnover. Employee turnover is high because there is lack of facilities, there is lack of monetary motivation, non-monetary motivation, lack of development, lack of training. So by the method of off-the-job training, employees' turnover rate decreases. Fewer distraction, they will be just focusing on enhancing their skills, the knowledge, because they are away from workplace, there is less distraction, feeling valued if employees are giving training, okay, on regular basis, through which they are becoming updated and upgraded, enhancing the knowledge, their skills, so they will feel valued by organization, okay, thus they feel motivated also. Opportunity to learn from others, different experts come from different organizations to give training, so they are getting the opportunity to learn from different experts around the globe. Feeling of confidence, if you learn something, okay, if you learn to handle some machine, if you learn to handle some softwares, or if you learn to handle the group of people by different methods, for example role play or for case study, so what will happen, your confidence will be enhanced. Okay, if your skills is enhanced, if your knowledge is enhanced, thus your confidence is also enhanced. So a feeling of confidence emerges due to of the job training. Employees can be confident. Yeah, same point. Can learn from outside specialists. Same point as this. Okay, now what are the disadvantages? Every method has some disadvantage also. Not effective, no production. See, because employees are taken away from workplace, so there is no production. They are just learning. They are not doing. Whereas in on-the-job training method, they were learning as well as doing. So there is no production. No production refers to no sales, no profit. And ultimately, that will not contribute towards achieving the vision. So this is one of the disadvantage of the job. Expensive. This is expensive method because experts are hired from outside. Of course, the organization has to pay them remuneration, accommodation, and other facilities. Okay, not effective. This is not effective somewhere because employees are not productive. Employees are not contributing towards production of goods and services, as well as this is costing to the company and not giving them output. So this is not effective method. Now this is the first method of the job training. So let's start with a case study. By studying a case situation, trainees learn about real and hypothetical circumstances and the action others take under those circumstances. See what happens in case study in MBA. There is a I would say prerequisite case study in every subject. So by case study, what happens? For example, take a point of view from student. Through a particular case, students analyze what were the problem that particular situation had and what were the solution, what were the recommendation and what solution they didn't apply. That's why they were not able to, I would say, grow the company or achieve the profitability. So by case study, this is one of the best method for making trainees or employees analyze analytical skills, okay, analyze problem solving skills. By this method, they analyze the situation, okay. By analyzing the situation, they are able to solve the problems, okay, whether it's a real situation or hypothetical, okay. Real refers to real cases that different scams have been taking place, for example Kingfisher, Satyam, for example Nirav Modi. So different methods, different cases were there. In that case, how are you going to solve that case? Using your mindset, using your perception, okay, using your attitude, how you're going to solve that case, or hypothetical, that's created somewhat artificially. Besides learning from content of the case, a person can develop decision. See, what is decision making? Decision making is choosing the best alternative from various alternative. For example, I have A project, B project, C project, D project. I have to choose any project depending upon the three factors: risk factor, time factor, and cost factor. We have studied in finance also. If you're choosing any in capital budgeting also, if you're choosing any project, so what the things you should analyze? What is the risk? What is the time period for future value of money, and what is the cost that will be incurred on that project? So decision making by case study, the trainees or employees learn to take decision Okay, choosing the best alternative, which is suitable for your organization, which will contribute towards achieving the vision, mission and profitability and increase the market share. Okay, when cases are meaningful, similar to work-related situation, there is some transference. There also is an advantage of participation through discussion of the case. It improves participant skills in problem analysis. See, in the case study, a group of people sit in this method of the job, and by expressing their ideas, their views regarding particular method or particular thing, the communication skill is enhanced. Okay, they're able to communicate properly. See, being a manager, being a marketing manager, finance manager, HR manager, IT manager, the most requisite is communication skills. How you're going to communicate to your subordinates, how you're going to make them work. So this is also very, very important, and how to solve the problems. Okay, and particularly brings home to the participant that nothing is absolutely right or wrong in the field of human behavior. See, in one case my perception will be different and your perception will be different. My perception to solve that case will be different, your perception to solve that case will be different. My perception regarding the problem will be different, your perception regarding the problem will be different. So in the end, in case study, nothing is wrong, right? It's upon the perception, how you're perceiving the things and how you are giving your personal solution in case study. Okay, survey results indicates that case study is considered as a best method for developing problem solving skills. Now role play, this is the second most important of the job training method. Okay, role playing believes in active participation. In role play, there is an active participation. Instantly they are participating. See, in when we went to do MBA, for like I did MBA from Shankaracharya Group of Institution, there was an induction program. In that also we did role play. Okay, different roles were assigned to the students. Like for example, I'm a finance manager, my friend was marketing, another was HR manager, other was IT, and we have to contribute towards production of goods and services. The budget was this, okay, the I would say target audience was this. So what is this role play? Active participation. Trainees are given a role. For example, you have to act as a quality manager, you have to act as a finance manager, you have to act as an IT manager. So, and in that situation, how you're going to solve the problem and how you're going to handle the subordinates and how you're going to contribute towards production. So role play is an active participation. In this method also, employees or trainees learn how to handle the situation. Okay, so let's start. This is a training method often aimed at enhancing human relations skills and sales skills. Okay, role playing can be defined as educational or therapeutical skills in which some problems involving human interaction, real, imaginary, is presented and spontaneously acted out. Role playing experience demonstrates the gap between thinking and doing. What I am thinking and what I am doing. Okay, what the trainees are thinking and what they're executing in this method, role play, they analyze that. Okay, it permits the practice of carrying out an action and makes it clear that good human relation requires skills. Okay, attitudinal changes are effectively accomplished by placing persons in specific role. Okay, see, for example, I am sales officer and I've been made as a marketing manager. Okay, this is role play. So how I'm going to analyze the attitude of different subordinates, how I'm going to work in a team or work in a group, okay, and contribute towards production of goods or services. So by role play, what happens, there is a good human relation connection. If I become a marketing manager, then I will analyze that, oh, marketing manager was saying this to me and he was correct, because this is a requirement and I was feeling there is a problem of ego or there is a problem of giving orders by him. So this, in this way, by role play, okay, the human relation is improved. It trains a person to be aware of and sensitive to the feelings of other. Yes, see, earlier I was sales officer and my role has been given as marketing manager. So now I'm going to analyze what the problem marketing manager is facing and how he is solving the problem, how we were troubling him, okay, how we were not listening to him or avoiding his orders. So in this way, they understand the feelings of other through role play. This information serves as a feedback of the effect his behavior has on other people. Okay, a fuller appreciation of the important part played by feeling in determining behavior in social situation is developed. Each person is able to discover his own personal fault. Okay, in this way they analyze their faults. Okay, it permits training in the control of feelings and emotions. Now simulation, this is the most important method of training, not just in the field of business, in different fields of business is also used, whether it's in aeronautics, okay, different whether it's in industries, chemical industry, iron industry, everywhere simulation is used. Okay, simulation is an approach that duplicates certain essential character of the real world. Okay, organization, so that the trainees can react to it as if they were the real things, and then consequently transfer what has been learned to the job. See, simulation is a creation of artificial situation, and it is, I would say, exact copy of the real situation where the employees can learn. Okay, that's not real, but that is actually exact imitation of the actual situation or actual world. Okay, as the name implies, simulation training is based on the reproduction of some aspect of job reality. It is totally based on job reality, a very popular training technique for higher level jobs in which employees must process large amount of information. The simulated environment should possess two important characteristics. First, physical fidelity, the extent to which to the training condition, task, equipment, surroundings, etc. similar to the work environment. Exactly, all equipments, all surroundings, everything should be same. For example, if I want to learn how to ride an aeroplane, there is a simulation. Everything is created artificially, but it's exact to the real world. So what happens, this type of simulation is used in the job or tasks which are at a high level, which requires more information, which requires more analytical skills, which require more of concepts. Okay, secondly, psychological fidelity. By using the equipment, simulator workers can practice, okay, new behavior and operate certain complex equipments free and danger. See, the most important advantage of simulation is there is a lack of danger or lack of accidents, lack of danger or lack of accidents. Equipment simulator can range from simple mock-ups to the computer-based simulation of complete environment. Some of them are utilized to train a single individual and the others are used to use for team training. These are used for single individual also as well as for training to a team. Now let's focus on classroom lectures. Okay, this is the most common way of training, okay, where the teacher trains the students or trainee by delivering lecture, by giving them information regarding any, like, they if their training is given regarding the software, they're going to give the training regarding the softwares, information regarding softwares, how to use that software. Okay, so let's start with the classroom lectures. Traditional, this is not modern, this is traditional method, okay, and direct method. Directly the communication takes place between the trainer and trainee. This is suitable method where the numbers of trainees are quite large. This is mostly useful where the numbers of trainees are large. Okay, this type of off-the-job training takes place in a classroom-like environment. Yes, and involves a trainer providing instruction in a lecture format, verbal presentation of information. Verbally, they are giving information. Okay, non-verbal communication is not here. There is a verbal communication. Trainees learn crucial skills needed for their job. Get to know their job responsibility. Get to know the job responsibility and have the opportunity to get to their question answers by experts. See, if they have any queries, if they have any doubts, they can ask from the trainer by the method of classroom lectures. In addition, classroom lectures may teach trainees the administrative or management aspect of their job, make them aware of the certain procedures, or provide them with instruction on a certain subject material. If they have a doubt how to use this machine or how to analyze the administrative or management aspect of the job, so trainer gives them full information in classroom lectures. Now let's focus on next, that's business games. A business game has been described as a dynamic training exercise utilizing a model of a business situation. In this game, participants are divided into various teams. They are placed in competition with each other in resolving some problems information which is supplied to them. Okay, the games illustrates the value of analytical techniques such as use of mathematical models to arrive at the optimum solution. For example, like we have studied it, OM, operational management, there were PERT, CPM, simulation, there were time series. So what happens through this mathematical models, okay, they what happens, trainees or students learn how to use a mathematical model and solve a problem. For example, PERTs and CPM are used to minimize the cost, carrying cost or ordering cost. So why this technique? So business games also somewhat, I would say, a technique to make the trainees, okay, improve their analytical knowledge, enhance their analytical knowledge, and by using different mathematical model and to come to a conclusion or solution. Business games have been developed to simulate interpersonal relation problems, financial budgets, issue, and resource allocation decision. It is simulation which consists of sequential decision making. Okay, see, by the usage of business games, participants learn, okay, to solve the problems related to finance, marketing, HR, okay, to take a decision by using a mathematical model and come to an optimum solution. It provides experience in the application of statistical and analytical method. Games are quite absorbing, provoking, interesting. See what happens if there are two teams, A and B. Okay, they are given same problem. So what happens, a group of people, they become very like focused because they are like given a challenge. If you win, we're going to give you a prize or hamper. So this is somewhat makes them more interesting towards solving that problem. So participants become more interested towards the work or towards learning that. So business games are somewhat a very, very, very predominant part of the job trading method. This games also gives the opportunity to trainee to learn from experience without actual suffering the real life consequences, bad or poor. Okay, they actually understand the problems and solve the problem without experiencing any consequences which is bad or poor. Now brainstorming, it is a group activity. See, in the picture only it says there is a group of people. Okay, technique by which efforts are made to find a conclusion for a specific problem by gathering a list of ideas and spontaneously contributed by its member. Okay, if there is any problem, okay, they are going to discuss and they are going to come to a conclusion. Now, audiovisual, this is a method of using audiovisual for making trainee understand the problems or understand anything. So let's start. Providing training by using films, television, video, presentation. This is the most common form of training. Okay, because this creates more impact. Like if you are showing pictures, if you are showing videos or clips, they will create more impact, longer impact to the trainees as compared to written one. Audiovisual based training like DVDs, films, PowerPoint, video conferencing, audio tapes and video tapes can be very effective.